We're your weather authority. We warn you first.
Good morning, everyone. Happy first day of September. As we can see, roofs by NICA Sky Tracker Midland. We still have mostly clear skies, still dark out there, an hour and a half before sunrise. Current temperature is 73 degrees, mild and muggy, warm and muggy this afternoon, but that might change as we head later this week and into the weekend. And as the remnants of Ida continue to move north and east, we could be seeing a change in that weather pattern as all that monsoon moisture that's in Arizona and New Mexico will move farther to the east, slowly but surely, with gusty winds and perhaps a change once again in those warm and perhaps rainy chances that we will see in the basin over the next couple of afternoons. But I just wanted to go over some of those August temperatures, and really across the board, mostly below normal for this time of year. And we do notice that the warmest conditions we saw was only at 100 degrees, and we only hit that once in the basin. That was on August 8th, as the coolest high temperature in August was at 81 degrees on the 17th. Now, those August low temperatures were even more impressive, only four times if our low temperature this morning verifies above average in the low 70s, as the warmest low temperatures were at 74, and the coolest was at 58 degrees, and that was at a daily record low on August 4th. So it's feeling a little bit more like fall for a bit, but that could be changing over the next couple of days, as today, feeling like summer in the basin. So if you want to go on a walk or go on a run, you should enjoy at least for the first half of the day. But we do have a slight chance of rain showers later this afternoon. So just bring the umbrella and the rain boots just in case. Some clouds mostly in the western basin this morning, and that might come into the Petroplex this afternoon. Maybe some pop-up rain showers for the afternoon commute, but most of that rain being in the drought-stricken areas in the western basin, and that will continue for the overnight, but it slowly but surely starts to move farther to the east. As remember, as Ida continues moving to the east, so does the entire atmosphere, and that's really been the big story over the past couple of days. Similar conditions tomorrow, with a little bit more in the way of rain for places like Brewster County, Fort Stockton, and Marfa. Any rain showers today will end mostly before midnight, with a low temperature of 71 degrees, with gusty winds also ending early. And those gusty winds will be the big story. They're fairly light right now, but they'll be ramping up this afternoon. Winds could be close to 10 miles per hour sustained this evening, but much more in the way of gustier winds as we head into tomorrow. 10 to 20 mile per hour sustained winds with these yellows, especially in Brewster County, indicating winds gusting to as high as potentially 30 to 40 miles per hour. Now, tomorrow is my birthday. Should be a great day to go out by the pool later in the day, but we still have a slight chance of rain showers with high temperatures, a little bit above normal for this time of year, in the low to mid 90s. Again, those gusty winds will be the big story and will continue to be the big story as we head into Labor Day weekend. Perhaps a little bit more in the way of mild and humid conditions with less clouds, but those clouds and warmer temperatures may return early next week with a slight chance of rain on Tuesday.